some unfortunate news for Nick.
All right, I'm going first.
Seriously?
Yeah,
seriously?
Misty's Wrath.
And finally, we see Marcus the starter, but it's Shaman, not the one that he would like to see. And I'm sure he didn't want to get two mulligans either. Certainly.
What a big prize.
Oh my god.
Marcus right here.
That sucks.
I feel like Marcus is going to be setting up even slower than he normally does, and despite having a positive matchup in terms of how his deck can do, can he still deal with this onslaught of really high damage attackers?
I'm going to use Leap.
Here we go, the finals kicking off here between Nick and Marcos. Classic matchup. And Nick begins with the town map flipping over his prizes. And he also has all these extra cards from the mulligan as well, so he's going to have a lot to work with. Should be able to get tons of mulligans in his card pile to set up.
Can't attack as long as
we're both here. Wow. We got a live audience out here.
Pass.
If there's anyone out there rooting for Nick in the Night March deck, can we make some noise? Does he have any support out there?
Tackle for 20.
A good amount of crowd.
All of Verbank.
How about Marcos, who's rooting for him and his Seismitoad Giratina deck? Something tells me a little bit comes from the territory of playing Nightmarch. I've seen it win so many tournaments. I think people just like to see something new win. Although I do find it funny, this is some of the most support I've heard in a while for Seismitoad EX. Another Pokemon that people like to hate.
Careless Tat.
Yeah, I think last year I was wondering who's from there. But again, if you're watching at home, get in the comments. Use that hashtag PlayPokemon. Let us know who you're rooting for. Nick Marcos, as Nick continues his first turn, goes with
Unknown
Feraligatr, getting Pokemon in the discard pile, playing as many item cards as he can on his first turn. We see another Ultra Ball, another Tank Marcher.
It's an escape rope, but only for your opponent. Cyclone Energy.
Cyclone Energy.
I do remember what they are. We have that. I do find that funny. Our new technology in every corner. I'm really happy to have that. I think there's some. Right. As casters, we just don't know what's in the prize cards yet. However, we don't get to see the deck as well as players do, as they're flashing through and shuffling.
Tied.
I'm happy to share this information with you guys.
Certainly. And again, Nick is continuing his turn. Actually plays down.
I wish the gold there. I cannot afford to take that.
He uses a setup on Shaman EX. The big story for Nick is going to be all about double colorless energy. Only plays those four energy cards in his entire deck.
Normally, I have a hard time.
Disruption and energy disruption with Crushing Hammer, Zerosic, Team Flare, Grunt, always to discard energy. And it's just, can Nick get enough attacks off, taking their prizes before all of his energy cards are discarded by Marcos? Yeah, that's going to be the hardest thing to come back from. You're really going to have to, I guess.
I really need that Feltrap back. I don't think so.
To recycle your energy. If you ever walk into a situation where you're hit with Quaking Punch and can no longer use the puzzle, it's going to be extremely
You want a Cassius.
A decent number of Pokemon hit the discard pile in the first turn. Maybe not as explosive of a start as Nick would want, but he's going to settle on it for now. Now, Marcos starts with the Shaven EX, not an ideal starter by any means. Plays Trainer's Veil, grab Ultra Ball, and usually the first Ultra
Fiery
Ball
charge.
This kind of a deck goes straight for that EX. You know what I just realized he has? I don't even know if we saw it once in that last matchup. He has four copies of Super Scoop up in here. That's actually an enormous card in these Night March matchups. With Fighting Fury Belt, your Pokemon EX get absurd numbers of HP. Seismitoad goes up to 220. And even if your opponent can use Night March, usually they're not doing enough damage to get one hit knockout. And then you can play Super Scoop.
Really need that.
Just start your turn with 8.
Pretty much pick up all the damage, replay it back down, and it's almost like your opponent's attack didn't even happen. So Super Scoop up, certainly a card that could come in handy here. We've seen Seismitoad sort of attaching.
Recharge.
I'm not playing a lot of
games. So taking Picking up a seismic toad on super skill, just dropping it a couple combos down is a really easy way to essentially heal all the damage.
And this is a bit of a strange matchup. There's kind of a fine line. You need to buy time to power up your Arcanine EX. Chaos Wheel is going to be the thing that gets you there. Oh, crushing hammer.
That'll bide some time. Damn, won't do it though.
But yeah, with the Vespa Quinn at its disposal, Typhlosion EX isn't as powerful as it would be against, say, a straight Night Rush deck. And that's exactly why you play the Vespa Quinn in your deck. This grass weak Typhlosion EX. So Marcos will get this turn when Quaking Coach takes the first prize in this game.
Got it.
But if Nick can have a Vespa Quinn double call his energy to respond with a B revenge, he can perhaps knock out Typhlosion EX in one attack.
Now, has Marcos not played a support yet this turn?
No, there we go.
Here we go. Support. I think he had a Lysander in hand. I think he was debating not terribly either, knocking out something like
same hand.
Best between
teammates on the top deck.
Wow, that's a
Vespa
Quinn
gift.
That's a number.
And the crowd's going wild. They love it.
Recharge.
Everybody at Lysander at the Kobe.
Is it win the game?
Pretty much.
Firestorm.
So, is this still a basic one?
You would probably struggle to find what it needed against the item lock.
I've not hit a single one.
Almost sure.
Gets to search for the Vespa Quinn. An instant response, an instant knockout on that
side with Tony
X.
Yeah, it's a level up, not a...
Are you just
His hand was long story short of what happened, I went back there to pack up my
Fighting Fury Bolt made it super difficult. It's like there weren't enough Pokemon in there for the
beat.
To get the knockout.
You have to exchange
your Pokemon. You have to show me. Ended up like being
Pokemon.
Are you sure?
I'm
sure.
Is any card is it's bad? We have to get a Pokemon.
This card beast?
Yeah, I'll show you now. I traded the Pokemon. I'll show you.
Nick takes those two prizes. Going to knock his hand down.
Yeah, but he's doing like 7 of this card, that's 90, times 2 is 180,
plus 20 for the
No, it's 7 in there, and then 90 times 2 is 180. Hit a 3 ball on the toe.
This card's not ready. Freeman bring things like Enhanced Hammer, Cerusic, things to discard the
energy. Take the Typhlosion.
That's one way the Nightmare deck can kind of up speed.
Unless you just
take the pick first, but it rocked it up.
Yeah, you were going to crop it.
No, pick Tina.
Yeah, it does have multiple MK play. Marcos is going to need a big turn this next turn. Probably something like one of his double energies that can attack Giratina. Something like an
Okay, we're going for
three. Nick's hand size way down.
Wait, it attacks us so bad.
No, for this crap. Push on his prize lead. He's already taken two prize cards. Perhaps if he has a Lysander, could bring out from the bench Pokemon EX, knock it out with, let's see, this Pumpkaboo it looks like. He has double puzzle of time. Actually, he can knock out the Koopa EX with the psychic weakness. Yeah, so Nick takes two more prize cards, goes down to just two. And if he knocks out one more Pokemon EX, he wins game number one.
And with all of these Pokemon EX, Nick pretty much just needs one more attack to do it. I don't know if Marcos drew anything immediately that helps him super scoop up, try and play that with the demon. I can't tell if that's an N in his hand or not. That could be a very large factor as well. I think what he needs here is just really
dig deep. I was stressing out all morning, worrying that I wasn't going to find energy,
it.
Enemy
to a small hand size. How was this match?
It was a little below 50 damage. A lot of people thought the Gyarados could, like, really outpace this. He got a turn when he was going, which I've seen Jack Carter's usually more than once.
Oh my god. Hey, that makes up for all the other kills that I flipped.
My god, I'm actually
in the I can't retreat.
Yeah, I know, but it doesn't really matter because I'm going to lose another freaking thing. Condition.
That helps a lot.
I'm going to go ahead and.
Yeah, he is the Shaman. Also has
ultra.
Here's a huge crushing hammer. Flipped in. Almost. Side 2, you want to discard off the bench here because you'll be, if everything goes according to plan, you knock off the active. Even though he's down and Nick is just one knockout away from taking this game, a Chaos Wolf and Steelix. This is one of those epic turns where you know your opponent has done all he can to prepare for what's coming at him. You discard the energy on board.
I need to hit one of these. I missed them both. See, you hit one and I would have knocked you out. Go ahead. Did you shuffle in all your waters?
Yeah.
So you are out of would any of us have ever guessed that Totino was a Nationals?
No.
It wasn't even on my radar at all.
Nope. I think they screwed up, though, at the beginning.
How?
Because Nick only had 7 Pokemon in the discard, and he attacked the Toad with the Fury Belt, and they said he knocked out the Toad.
He's got to have 9.
Yeah. So I don't know. He played teammates, so he couldn't, like, discard the toolbar and gross it.
That could make a firestorm on Burbank.
I don't know, I didn't see the whole, like, sequence.
What are you doing?
I don't know, you said a firestorm.
No.
He might have had, like, megaphone or something, I don't know. But no, he quickly
comes. 23. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12,
17, 18, 19, 20.
That's not really what I'm concerned about right now.
That's all I'm going to do is tell
you. Very good shape.
No double test.
So, okay, so, I'm going to poke a turn. I'm going to throw that.
Attach return.
Flashlight.
Flashlight. Firestorm.
A really desperate Lysander. Looks like Nick just has to retreat to Pokemon. Pass the turn, and now it's back. Orko's attaches and goes a third double dragon energy to his active Pokemon.
That's game over. He can't hammer, he can't get rid of all that double dragon, all that energy.
Taking it out of the chaos wheel. What can Nick do? I mean, I guess just Lysander
so on the board. It's only
the has had any way to move it. He does run a lot of cards in his deck. He could move it. But then that means Lobstones or Super Scoop Ups or AZ.
He probably has a float in his hand or something like that if he's attaching all that energy to the active.
Yeah, normally this catches me in this mad comeback.
Even at this point, even if Shaman in range for 2-price knockoffs, just end the game.
Yep.
And there's only two ways I can see.
I have a lube right now.
I had four that I attached and fire recharged.
And play Lysander in the same turn. We do see his giant full art glaring face at the top of the discard pile, so we know that that's not common.
That's such a big play.
I know you have a double gas in your hand.
I guess it looks like he's going for an N at this point.
Ooh.
And I guess he's just going to say, you know what? You'll get your special energy back, but you're not going to have item cards.
I just don't want to get one shot. Because everything's on this Arcanine right now. I wish I could tell you what's in my hand right now, but I can't. I can't really check it. So I'll try and eat back with baby roll.
Dimension Valley Lysander. He does find a sick card. There's double colorless.
Hit seven water.
Dimension Valley. Wait, no! It was the wrong block. Isotope can't cut it. Hokumu takes the back up. Oh, nice. I have another Pokemon in there. There's nine dice.
Two,
pips. Let's see.
Three.
Four, is that game one?
Six. Seven.
Eek.
Eight.
Oh!
Game one.
Wow. He did Lysander the Toad and just.
Yeah.
Wow.
The guy could have Skyled for the AZ, but instead he would have played Lysander or something like that.
Oh, that's not smart.
Like, he should have Skyled for the AZ.
Fire recharge. Fire recharge.
Nice. Just a little bit of breathing room, just one opening, they can take it in any gust. And, I mean, that was it. Nick attacked three times that game and took six prize cards. I think Marcos, he had an interesting decision on that final turn. He could have either used the N and went for the quick, and I think most of the time that ends up giving him a win.
That was my point. I needed a fire recharge.
Extra energy to the Caratina, but you almost wonder, would it be spent all of those double colorless energies on
pretty sure that was like all water energy in there.
So discard all but seven. Take the top seven. The rest.
Oh, Steve. Demon.
Water's in
it. It's nothing to do with the water. It has to do with the crocodile.
I like our
water.
Game right
that
there.
Was probably the game, yeah.
Because I'm about to firestorm.
Sometimes it's the opposite. You have all
Let me see.
See, Tyler. You encouraged me to buy this hat.
Double fire here.
Illinois. Get home safe, man.
This is the matchup for either. This is the reason why I play it. I don't want to get Oko'd.
Yeah.
So Firestorm. Or at least I don't want to get Oko'd half. Imagine a focus ban existed today.
Oh my god, that'd be so ridiculous.
That would make Night March not as powerful. Focus banning your shamans.
Gosh darn it. Because you keep getting more of those. I just want you to use them all up.
Because the problem is when I play them, when they go back into the deck.
I know.
Not the one I play.
I know. That's the reason I hate them.
I need a full Gator line to go back into the deck.
Open this again.
Yeah, that's kind of hard with how much of your deck is. This is a more even matchup than I think it is.
The
bands.
Bands,
yeah, that's what does it. Jay Skwazinski told me to play Chaos Gems.
You definitely could.
Because at some point, I don't really need trainers anymore.
No, I mean, you were able to.
Because I could just keep fire recharging. Yeah. So yeah, I should play my own.
Duke the Pack.
I didn't see any.
There's no Crocodile.
Worst case is if you find something missing, he booked it for another one. What the hell is this?
I didn't want to start with a fire type, or else you're just gonna munch it with the turtle. So,
like, there's no way.
Risk.
Oh god, what am I doing with that?
I've been flipping so many tails today.
Lack of a, yeah, Chris has.
Oh, nice.
The lack of a cleft right here is really
bad. I'm not doing much better over here. Put four super speed up tails.
Baby rule.
And we even see a Lysander under
the Shaman EX
trying
to chip away some prize cards. Yeah. Oh, they're at 5 minutes. Yeah. So this guy's
going to be focused, man. I need a startling megaphone. Drop ass.
Drop ass. Guys, check out drop ass.
If you can somehow win, here's the double.
Who? How are you talking about?
And now, Nick, it's still huge this turn. He can use it to Sky Return and remove Shaman.
Yeah, that's gonna knock out the best thing. If I got him.
Making that Lysander pretty much worthless.
Oh,
and, you know, just give Marcos information. It says, hey, I got double Golas energy now. Yeah, it's gonna go back to my hand, so it could spark an end for Marcos. Saying, no, so much of that.
In his hand.
But, hey, denying the two prize cards is extremely important. So yeah, he does it versus Secret Hand. He has a lot of, but I know he wants to draw their energy out of the
Secret
Hand.
That's fine. I don't care about that one. He knows, attack wasn't going to do much anyway.
Made the basic
players. Dude,
just
you don't win. Oh, yeah,
you just have to
bring it to me next turn. Yeah, if you end this turn, it gives you a chance to...
Oh, you're the only player.
Once again, gives you a chance to draw into another double drag.
Oh my god, no.
He's actually correctly identified.
You're okay, I don't have any. I don't have any fires in there. And I have no way to discard them.
Discard energy, and then chaos be able to knock out the other thing with energy. But when there's nothing on board, there's nothing to...
Why is it called Cinnabar City Gym and not Cinnabar Island?
Every time it's on board, it's actually...
make his way onto the best plan. And Nick will be able to score a knockout here on the side of the
right now.
Rob just wants to do too much for him. Yep. Oh, no.
Actually,
There's no shame.
It's already there for the color.
Where's the stupid? We saw in the first game. Now we baby roll. No, finally, sweep decks. Away. Got it.
Take the first card. I
need to draw something. Kyle is
Kyle is on the
player.
It does
1 point. Wish I had this one.
No, it's called Balloon Berry. It's just a one-use
one. I don't know what I'm doing.
Put a stupid focus band on it.
No Pokemon at all. I want to get the triple fire recharge going.
No.
Fire recharge, or no, I don't even have any. Oh yeah, I do, I have one fire recharge. You know what? Let's start sweeping. I'm gonna try sweeping. Fire smoke. Is he not getting Giratina online?
He is, because he's there.
Oh, he just Chaos Wheels?
Yeah, he just Chaos Wheels.
I think the key is that Nick plays, I think he plays Enhanced Hammer and Zero Suit.
Yeah.
And that really helps against Totina. Not so much against Toad, like, Tina Dark, but, like, Totina it does.
What the heck am I looking at?
Eek. Rip. I think Marcos on that turn was
certainly taking one. Someone's like, you just cut it.
Oh my god, stop flipping heads.
I need to actually get this deck, like, built for real life. Forget me.
I have her. I
need to get it. I actually really want to do, like, I wish I could, like, turn into this format. Baby roll?
Yeah.
And just like that, all those hard-earned double dragon energy that took so long to attach are going to be discarded.
Did he Zerosek and Hand Hammer?
He used Zerosek and then double puzzled.
Oh, gosh, it's dirty. How many prizes left?
Nick has 4.
He's gonna win.
Marcus has 3.
He's gonna win. It's already over. He's gonna kill that Tina. Or no, he's not. He will next turn, probably. The only thing he can do is, like, remove the energy, and Wiggy Punch with a Fighting Fury belt, not get knocked out.
During my turn, and when it goes to your turn, that is.
Oh, why do you play it for them?
Slow King.
Oh, I see.
Or Dark Vile Bloom, I mean, that works too. Oh my god, stop it!
Double recharge.
No surprise to see how he got all the way here to the finals. And, you know, he's very close to being national champion at this point. And you can tell he's really playing himself out of the situation of Quaking Punch. Using a lot of his item cards, while he's due to a Quaking
search to knock out my Joltik, guess what? I can grab any two cards I want out of my deck. That includes
Baby Roll,
which I would really like right now. He's not going to be in that chaos. He'll still finally get to attach.
So we see a huge super scoop up here for Marcos. Gets the tails.
He's got another one in hand.
All right, he needs to hit this one. And it is heads. All right, so he's going to be able to pick up Shaman EX, set up, and draw into his other puzzle of time. He has one in hand already. He can then play the two puzzle of time to grab Brad Silvercola's energy and maybe Floatstone out of his discard so he can retreat and Quaking Punch. But actually, looks like he's going for some double dragons. Saying, you know what? Quaking Punch didn't work last time. Let's go try to power up one more Giratina EX to close out this game and have some time as long as Nick doesn't knock it out.
And, wow, does Nick have any way to get this around?
Please die. How much are you doing?
I see. It's one piece of puzzle of time. An ultra ball. I don't know if he has.
Even with the numbers, it's like we just right.
I'm not even sure if that's.
Band.
No.
Yes.
Steve, what was the Hyatt Wi-Fi actually?
Do you remember? It's different for every. Yeah, it's different for every person in their room.
So his last name was number.
Yeah. Pretty frail play to just haphazardly attach to a double dragon.
Pretty smart, actually.
This might actually work out. Your chaos will could return.
And Nick actually needs a Lysander to bring up the bench Giratina EX and a double Colossus energy to immediately.
I need to hit one of my fiery charges.
Double tails, double tails, double tails, double tails.
I just need to hit one. Unless I have a Typhlosion in hand. Which I don't, but I might be able to get. Is there a Typhlosion in here that I should have? No, you know what? Let's try and make the odds a little bit better here. Double fire recharge.
Oh my god! Stop! I play fake expands for this crap.
You should, they're really good.
I'm just saying, you know, this, it would prevent this stupid Arcanine from killing me.
It would.
That's enough
close. That's enough close to the time.
Considering that Feraligatr will deal an OHKO right back to it, even with the stadium.
We just OHKO each other. My weakness doesn't matter that much, I don't think. These need to be Chaos Gems, in my opinion. My weakness doesn't mean anything.
No, because like, Feraligatr's going to do that much damage anyway.
Almost every time. The only problem I think I have is, like, if I start, like, Cyndaquil or Growlithe, your Totodiles could just, like, destroy me.
I can just daunt you, yeah. Little buddy. Little buddy. I saw you earlier. There he is.
Time. Once again, Enhanced Hammer, Zerosic, both of those double dragon energy, kiss him goodbye, going straight to the discard pile.
There it is, the hammer.
You hit the Typhlosion.
No, this probably cries.
This is everything.
I have two Typhlosions. I play four.
You have each of your opponent's basic attacks cost one more colorless.
At this point, I think you only have one shot. And
that's on the bench.
And hope your opponent
you play when you don't have fire.
And here we go.
Four of those. But don't want to attach an energy for the turn.
Just play four of those. I don't understand.
You can then play Crushing Hammer.
Also, you have to have the pick.
Oh, jeez.
Move the Shaman, and he runs out of cards and loses.
Oh, man. All these players are actually on very low card counts. It looks like there's just one card left on Marcos' side as well.
So he might run out of cards first.
I wonder if he has even something like an end to refresh here. If he's just holding the Shaman in place hoping that he can knock it out. I just don't see the firepower. All he has is a double dragon.
So you like
doing everything you can.
I mean,
I don't know who actually has this.
And Nick's actually going to retreat. Even with the secret base of play,
I don't know if
that would be a cute idea.
Yeah. I had really bad
friends. What goes to here?
It was my eyes are just having
to swap it up. Sure. I think the double dragon.
Freaking kidding me.
One hit.
He refreshes deck if he has no edge.
Definitely
I need to run like
the
a
dick win.
I need to run like a gas attack or something to deal with that.
There was no
ability, no Pokemon powers,
nothing.
contest hall? Contest hall?
That's
his only way to do anything.
Triple fire recharge.
Two Gyaradoses. A lot of times you chain kill two of them, they're fucked.
Baby roll.
Well, yeah, that's for yeah. Well, you know, right.
Pick one.
Six, seven.
Probably.
I have seven, so I'm doing 80, which is enough because you do 10 damage.
I don't know. Maybe, I guess, if you had access to a
Lysander, you could super scoop up. Tied. Please die.
I put him
please no. Please yes.
Please no.
You want Chancy face down.
Yeah.
I
like Arcanine.
Alright, then it's gonna.
Chancy face down.
Nick Robinson won.
Yes.
National champion. Congrats, Nick.
Congratulations, Nick Robinson.
Nightmarch.
Best we march.
You know, he's taken the Nightmarch deck all the way to a national championship like
we can look.
Good for him.
It's pretty awesome.
Now I have to see him in all my cities next year. He's from Iowa. Yeah. I beat him all the time.
I beat him in the cities.
Yeah. He's... I don't know. He's a really good player, but there's a lot of really good players in this game. I just feel like he hit what he needed, hit the nuts, hit his matchups. That could have been a lot of other good players. Like, it's, I kind of felt that way about Worlds, too. Like, everybody at Worlds could have won the tournament, you know?
Anyone who makes it there.
It's no surprise to me. It's a surprise to other people that maybe that he won, but I had a feeling. I knew that he was a good player. I know he's a good player. All right. There's like no reason to like do damage to you because I'm doing one shot anyways.
So. Yeah, you're
triple fire recharge. One hit. Let's say three tail would really trigger me right now.
Trainer, I actually fucked Jay.
Language, dude.
I'm sorry, my bad. Anyways, he's playing SP. I'm playing Gyarados, and I'm just like, I have Azelf out. Well, that's pretty cool.
Tell me you prize the other Arcanine. I don't know if you play three or four.
Although I do play three. Although I can't do like a deck search right now. I could do this.
Oh, you can't make this, I'm sorry.
There's three Arcanines in the discard pile.
There is?
Yeah. That sucks.
I'm gonna attach that here then.
Yeah, that's what I was just gonna say. You probably want to start attacking with the Typhlosion.
I wouldn't though. Because you're gonna be blue.
It's not good.
Finally got this where I wanted to.
Don't let me dunk you. If you can do it. Yeah, if you want it, I am weak. Baby
bees! I don't think you can dunk it.
Yeah.
I would have done it. Just because.
Downpour 2. Attach one over here. Tap.
He is the card that wins in the matchup.
Baby roll.
I needed it. Draw for turn. I could Wrath right now and figure out what's up. I don't think that's a good idea right now. So. Triple fire recharge. Yep. I need to hit two of these.
We have a game this deck.
Oh.
Down goes the third one.
It is
so funny. Trogdor.
After you do
how many cards are left in your deck?
Six.
Erica.
I'm not gonna draw.
Alright.
So I need to attach, triple fire HR, start powering up another Typhlosion. Hopefully get it going. I need to flip heads on Flame Burst because I actually want to, like, I don't care if I damage myself.
This double gust.
Now I wish I put that here.
Baby roll.
Cliffy used Attract.
Rip.
The way that we play friendly.
Was it only two?
Yeah. I shuffled them all back in previously, so I had, I downboarded the two so I could knock it out.
Double guess.
Two of them. This one. One of the Typhlosions.
Pass to you.
Triple fire recharge.
Oh my lord.
I have that in your opening. I just
stopped.
Got it. Otherwise, oh my god.
That's actually what I was going to grab.
I actually was just going to retreat, but this works too.
Oh my god.
Mad plays. Flame burst. Get out of here.
20 yourself.
Still, get out of here.
I'm going to avenge that one in a cruel and unusual fashion. I need 3 in the discard to do 40, which is 80 to you. I'm just going to downpour 1.
This is super close.
Retreat. Out.
No collector or just you?
That is a valid point.
GTFO. Get out of here.
Was that 2?
Oh, yeah.
Or 3?
3. 10, 20, 30, 40 weakness. 80. And you took 20 from yourself.
I know you did. So, you got 2 to play your last right.
Here we go.
I had this
time one. Oh my god.
I could do it multiple times. I have all 4 in my deck. I've never used it.
Really gonna bring this down to a freaking clip.
I am, because I'm not gonna one. I'm not gonna knock that out.
No, you're not.
Pick one. Right, but pick a Growlithe so I have to retreat it.
Yeah.
Double fire recharge.
Okay. Alright, attach from hand.
I actually don't have one in my hand.
Oh my god.
Axel.
There we go. There it is.
Here we go. Right. Here it is. This is game right here. Well, if you knock that out, it's pretty much game anyway.
Axel.
Here we go.
And here it comes.
You're baby rule. Good game. Really good game.
God, that was
ridiculous. Oh man, that was so close.
Oh my god, I can't believe I just got 2 of my fire. Huh? Feels not terrible.
I'm sorry.
No, dude.
The focus bands did it. The focus bands. Not in that second game, but the first game.
No, the first one. Oh my god.
Right there.
So ridiculous.
Kind of play Chaos Gems. That was really good.
As if I was going to make it more frustrating now. Yeah. I got to start up in the Calipa Stadium.
You're going to have to start
literally like
up
3
in your
healing fields.
You can't just one shot anybody now.
Maybe I'm just going to. I mean, it doesn't work against that deck. I was just going to say, I'll just put the blasted Steelix.
What?
Oh, that's not going
to
help.
I'm putting some freaking goop gas attacks in here to deal with that crap. I'm not putting up with that.
Oh, man.
Cheers, you two.
Yeah.